Canon probably doesn't like me making this tutorial, but here we go. Want a free, no subscription alternative to EOS VR Utility and Adobe Premiere for your Canon R5C right here and the brand new Canon R7 with the new diffusion lens? You are in the right place. In this video, I will show you how to use the free DaVinci Resolve to transform 4K raw dual fisheye lens footage into immersive 180 format for Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest. Plus, I will share an improved, easier calibration workflow on DaVinci Resolve Studio for 8K Canon R5C or really any pair of camera like the two Insta360 GO 3S. You can use my old STMap tutorial right here to quickly stitch any camera into VR180 without even leaving Resolve. Not only will DaVinci Resolve save you money, but it also reduces rendering paths, enhance image quality, and offer Hollywood-level color grading and VFX too. We got a lot to cover, so let's dive right in. Hi, filmmaker. It's Hugh and Kimchi here.
I'm on vacation. Don't bother me.
With the release of Canon R7 and the new DaVinci lens, everyone can now create immersive 180 videos on Apple Vision Pro without paying for expensive editing software like Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve Studio. The free DaVinci Resolve supports up to 4K input and output, so you can use it with the R7 setup right here. The problem is, you still need to pay for the subscription to Canon for the EOS VR Utility. Don't get me wrong, EOS VR Utility is very powerful and worth every penny with the latest version. But if you don't create immersive content every month, having a monthly subscription might not make too much sense financially. And that is why I will teach you everything in DaVinci Resolve. The free version of DaVinci Resolve actually does not support 3D or stereoscopic workflow, but thanks to Angel Hazelton, the creator of Kartaverse, we now have a powerful and free software package within DaVinci Resolve Fusion. If you do not have Reactor and open source Karta VR package, follow this tutorial to install and update everything. After installing Reactor, go to Workspace, Reactor, open Reactor, under Kartaverse, just check everything, install and update. If you use Insta360 GO, there are some free plugins here will take your reframe video to the next level in 8K. Don't worry, 360 users, I will go over them in my next tutorial. Now we have the prep work done, let's start the fun. Drop in a raw fisheye clip shot on the Canon R7 with the new dual fisheye lens. If you do not have the camera yet and want to follow along, I provide this exact same footage for free to download. The link down below. Right click in edit page and create a new timeline from selected clip. Uncheck use project setting. Go to format and make sure the resolution is 3840 by 1920 if you have the free DaVinci Resolve and 1496 by 2048 if you have the paid studio version. The only downside of the free version is that Blackmagic kept you at 4K UHD and Canon R7 actually captured true 4K, so you lost a little bit of final resolution. We use 3840 here as I assume most of you start with the free version. The frame rate is 29.97 for the US and 30 for the UE. And click create. Go ahead and edit your video here. Then right click on the finish edit and create a Fusion comp. Go to Fusion tab. Use the keyboard shortcut shift spacebar to bring up the select to search menu. Search for KVR crop stereo and KVR viewer and add them to the node trees. Connect them to the Pi by pressing Shift and drag them onto the line. Click 1 on your keyboard to bring up the KVR Crop Stereo node into window number 1. The idea of KVR Crop Stereo is to crop your left and right image circle exactly to remove all that space we do not need. Open your inspector window if you have not already. Under View Mode, select Original Image. Now you can use the on-screen control to resize the green box exactly touching the edges of the left lens like so. Try to be very precise if you can. See this up and down arrow right here? You can move the green box around to cover the entire fisheye. Okay, now you can click the crop size 1 to 2 button right here to match the image 2 resizing to image 1 you just did, and move the right arrow to position the crop to the right eye circle. Now under view mode, go back to final result, and you see the black area is gone now, which is exactly what we want. Under stereo mode, choose horizontal, as this is a side-by-side video. You can use a vertical stack if you are doing VR 360. So don't think this node is only for VR 180. It will work on 3D 360 as well. More on that later. Then we check swap eye, as Canon swapped the left and right eye in the raw Fisheye format. This is only for Canon-based camera like R7 or R5C. If you film with dual sensor camera like the 2x4K GO 3S, then you don't need to swap. Now go to KVR viewers node, click 2 on your keyboard to bring the viewer into your window number 2. If you don't see 2 window, click right here to toggle single or dual window mode. Under image projection, choose Fisheye, as this is a Fisheye input from KVR crop stereo node. Stereo is horizontal side by side, and check solid alpha to remove transparency. Under image, we uncheck auto resolution and select the width and height to 1920, basically the height of your timeline resolution, as the image resolution is calculated based on one eye. Check the final image resolution here should be 3840 by 1920, the timeline resolution. If you have a studio version, it should be 2840 right here. Basically, match your timeline resolution. I'm on a Mac here, as my final goal is to create a spatial video for Apple Vision Pro. However, Apple Vision Pro do not directly integrate it with DaVinci Resolve at this time of recording. So, the best way to check stereo is to use these ugly 3D glasses. They cost about $1 from Amazon, and I will put the link down in the description. You need to get them to review stereoscopic 3D, so get them! If you look at the size of the door right here, you see the line is not straight. The reason is that the RFS 3.9mm dual Fisheye lens is not 180 degrees like the Canon RF 5.2mm did in an old dual Fisheye lens. They are around 144 degrees. So reduce the diagonal field of view to about 155 degrees look pretty good to me. This is not a rocket science, you don't need to be exactly 144 degrees. Adjust the FOV when you think the image looks correct to you. To help see the final result like what you see on YouTube browser, we are going to add another KVR viewer right after the first one. We pipe the output onto the new KVR viewer. This node is just for preview only. We are not gonna use it in the final render. If you are on a PC, you don't even need that. Just wear your Meta Quest VR headset right here to check the stereo. If you don't know how, check out this tutorial right here in great detail. Click function F2 key on the KVR viewer nodes to rename it. The first one should be called Fisheye underscore underscore KVR viewers, and the second one is review underscore KVR viewer. The review KVR should be 180 degree VR in image projection and horizontal in stereo. Make sure to uncheck tiny planet and check anagraph. Now, you can move around the frame just like how you see it on YouTube to check the stereo. Also, make sure you wear the 3D glasses to see it. Personally, I like to check stereo this way instead of wearing a VR headset, as this is so much faster. Double click here to reset the center after you are done. Go back to Fisheye KVR viewers by hitting the keyboard number 1 to put it on a window number 1. If you see the Canon EOS VR Utility output, they all have a lens mask feather on the edges. You can do it here as well. Under masking, play with the mask diameter and mask softness to taste. From here, you can go to the color page to color this and the deliver page to render it. But if you are like me, obsessed to give viewers the best 3D imagery, I will recalibrate the stereo 3D even further. Go back to Fusion page and KVR crop stereo node, copy the KVR crop stereo to make a copy to backup. Make the preview window bigger by hiding node tree here and put into single view mode. Hit fit to comp. You can turn on anagraph mode right here. Move the on-screen control of left and right view until you remove all disparity on the wall, which is the furthest distance in this particular scene. Don't just move one eye, split the difference. Okay, this is pretty good. adjust the vertical disparity to make sure there is absolutely no vertical disparity. Remember to turn off anaglyph in the KVR crop stereo when you're done. Check in the review KVR viewer note, much better 3D now. If you have the paid version of DaVinci Resolve Studio, there are old school stereo tools you can use to make this task even easier. Reset the KVR crop stereo with your backup copy right here, shift spacebar to search for global align. Then add an anaglyph node after global align. In global align stack mode here, set it to horizontal stack. In the anaglyph mode, set it to horizontal as well. Zoom in the view window on anaglyph node, but put your inspector on global align. Set the translation X and Y to split. Now move the dial wheels right here to fine tune the disparity like you just learned. The split mode will move both left and right eyes together in sync. A lot easier to get the perfect result. The 2009 Avatar 3D movie by James Cameron used this exact technique to get the ideal stereo. So you are using a Hollywood level stereoscopic too. Don't forget to drop Kimchi a like if you feel Hollywood. What if your fisheye lens is not perfect like Canon? Let's say that you use two Insta360 GO3S or two GoPros and there is some funky fisheye distortion you need to correct. Right after global align, shift spacebar to search for KVR lens stereo. Set the stereo to horizontal in the mode dropdown. You can use panel tools. Panel tools are great for barrel distortion correction. Brown Corandi is like Nuke or Mystica VR K1 to K4 setting. If you come from a Nuke or Mystica VR background, you can use this. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, stick to panel tools. Make sure your windows are on review KVR viewers. No, change the radiant distortion A, B, or C value. You see the lens distort, but it is still in perfect 3D. So let's say your subject is way too close to the camera, causing people to cross-eye. You can push them back using this node and not breaking the stereo principle. Don't overdo it though, but you can still save your scene if you mess up in filming. Drop Kimchi a like as he shared these secret tips to you. You can use the same A, B, and C value to correct non-standard fisheye lens like the Insta360 GO 3S or 2X GoPro Max lens mount. By the way, is it GoPro Max 2 really coming? Here's a leaked image. So, if you are not a fan of Insta360, maybe you can wait for the GoPro this year. Okay, this is your final note 3. If you are using the same camera, you only need to do this correction once, and you can copy and paste on all the cuts in your timeline. Let's go to color page, add a correction note, and drop in my Canon C03 base technical LUT or the Canon official CMD709 LUT to transform it into REC709. Do your grading here for this tutorial, then go to the deliver page. Your output resolution will be just timeline resolution. If you have the Mike Swanson Spatial Video MVHDVT script, you can check trigger script at end of render job right here. I have the VR180 metadata injection script right here for YouTube VR distribution. I will use it to save myself some time. If you want to learn how to create this script, don't forget to follow this channel and hit the notification bell. You can now add to the render queue and render your final video to check on Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest 3 right here. For Canon R5C, it will be exactly the same except the timeline resolution now is 8192 by 1496 in true 8K and with a 180 degree diagonal field of view. This workflow is pretty easy and free under 4K, but not the fastest, especially if you have a low GPU VRAM computer. The fastest way is to actually follow my original DaVinci Resolve tutorial right here to use the STMap template on your edit page. So rewatch that if you need a refresher. But ignore the STMap generation part of that tutorial. You can use what you just learned in this video to generate STMap much faster for Canon R5C or any dual camera setup. First, download the STMap comp from Andrew, link in the description down below, and drop it into the empty space of your Fusion page. Put the input loader in window number 1 and STMapper in window number 2. Here, show how to generate an STMap for the red or Nikon V-Raptor with the Canon all-dual fisheye lens. If you go to the notes, they are similar to what you just learned. The only difference is all notes are connected to an STMap generation node. And at the end, you can use the ST saver to save a STMap into a local hard drive. So just calibrate your lens at the KVR crop stereo node like here using this template and save the STMap to use the inline STMap effects in your edit page. That's it! Very easy! This tutorial only covered the Fisheye to VR180 part of the workflow. Want to learn how to add 2D video and graphic into 3D 180 correctly? Just like VR paints to fit in Adobe Premiere but completely free in DaVinci Resolve? Curious about converting VR 180 video into spatial video on Apple Vision Pro using only DaVinci Resolve without Mystical VR? All this topic and more are coming in this brand new immersive video editing series exclusively on this YouTube channel. So if you haven't already, subscribe and hit the bell to stay up to date. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and a big shout out to Andrew Hazelton. Without him, there wouldn't be any immersive video or virtual production workflow in DaVinci Resolve. Now, go practice, ask your question in the comments, and I will see you in the next tutorial or talk to you in the comment section down below. Ciao!